Good morning, guys. Good morning to you all. Today we are talking about menopause and mental health. Thank you very much for support of my channel, especially my Cuban doctor, Dr. Maria from Zimbabwe, Dr. Calva. Thank you very much for your very good comments, especially for my last video about postpartum depression and puerperal psychosis. Today I want to continue my presentation about menstrual-related mental disorder, and today we are talking about menopause and mental health. Why about menopause? Because female mental health, it's very important for each country, very important. To know about mental symptom at the time of menopause, exactly, it's very important for everyone, not only for women, because my subscriber, my friend, you are my sister, and exactly, you know that everyone is passing through menopause. It's a really normal procedure. Everyone is passing. But somebody can develop problem, somebody can't. Why? I try to explain for you and help you to pass menopause more quietly without serious mental problem. Menopause, it's a normal transition. Everyone must know. It's normal transition for women, and every woman will experience menopause differently. For example, why really I decided to make my presentation according to my wide experience in psychiatry about menopause and mental health? Because according to media in United States, more than 1,300,000 women are expected to reach menopause every year. Exactly, it's too many women pass menopause. Everyone in menopause is suffering. Somebody suffering few months, somebody suffering few years. And exactly, everyone has different symptom of mental problem at the time of menopause. And I try to explain for you and help you how to survive in this situation, and if it's necessary, go to see counselor, psychologist, or psychiatrist. About age, in the United States, middle age of menopause 51, but exactly it can be between 47 up to 51 and up to 57, but more common age, 51 years old. Like I explained, menopause is a normal transition, but somebody can get serious problem, somebody not. In some cases, menopause and the reduction of estrogen can impact of someone's mental health or exacerbate or serious mental illness. Especially if somebody had mental problem before, any type of mental illness, it's schizophrenia, bipolar, general anxiety, no, too many. Exactly, menopause affected mental condition in its coming exacerbation. Really, you must be ready, you must understand that, and waiting, you must be ready. Menopause is coming, 100% I can get exacerbation. I must be ready for this condition. What a little bit explained for you about menopause. Menopause is coming after 12 months when you got last menstrual cycle. For example, you got last menstrual period, 12 months, you don't have anything else, and after 12 months is coming menopause. The 5 to 10 years period before menopause, it's perimenopause, and when estrogen and hormone levels begin to drop. And this time, between 5 to 10 years, it's called perimenopause. But it's what it's mean, perimenopause. It's 5 or 10 years before menopause, estrogen level, the hormone levels is begin to drop down. And in this situation, it's coming exactly problem. Coming problem, different type of problem. What it's mean hormones? Hormone, it's our messenger in the body. They stop, speed up, or slow down our physical and chemical function. And if we have, for example, suddenly low level of estrogen, it's affected everything. It's affected our brain, it's affected our nervous system, and affected our body. Ovarius, it's like center. Our ovarius is center of estrogen and progesterone, like key. It's two key hormones. They control our reproductive function, reproductive system, including our menstrual cycle and fertility. And if it's going to be low level, suddenly disbalance, ABCD, exactly, it's coming problem. During menopause, estrogen depletion can bring combination of hormonal and biochemical fluctuation, which can lead to change our physical condition, condition of brain and nervous system. Effect of estrogen depletion. Study shows that really hormonal fluctuation and change in estrogen level exactly can bring for us chemical dysfunction in brain and affect not only brain condition, it's affect all nervous system, all body, and ABCD. Due to depletion in estrogen, a woman may experience, firstly, exactly physical symptom. Usually if we are talking about menopause, and I did presentation for students, we have really three type of symptom for menopause. Number one, it's exactly physical symptom. Physical symptom, and from physical symptom, just the same. Number one, it's hot flush. Hot flush, it's intense sense of heat in upper half of body. And this one, intense sense of heat in upper half of body, it's exactly distressful condition and affect occupational and social function of each woman. Only depends of for how long this hot flushing. Like I explained, for somebody it can be for a few months, but for somebody for a few years. And exactly this hot flushing affected social and occupational function of woman, private life, and finally affected her emotional condition. Just the same, this hot flushing or physical symptom can provoke depressed. Number two, in this situation, mood change. Just the same due to hormonal disbalance. Mood change can bring for us irritability, feeling of sadness, lack of motivation, difficulty of concentration, exactly depression between mild and moderate. We usually don't have severe, but mild and moderate typical for menopause. This cognitive change, because woman started complain, it's a symptom really of depression, when is going to be poor attention, poor concentration, and woman can't cope with her occupational task, you know. In this situation, exactly, it's very, very difficult. Usually, we are talking about empty nest. It's a very popular term in United States, in UK, because not only low level of estrogen can provoke depression in menopause. Exactly, social environment, just the same. Why? Because menopause, like said, middle age, common age is plus 51. At this time, woman is very social, stable, kids, adult, you know, usually they are living family, and she is worried about pension, you know, she is worried about sexual life, she is worried about partner, sometimes money issue, everything, this combination of social disturbance exactly affected woman, not only low level of estrogen. And combination of low level estrogen, hormonal dysfunction, plus social dysfunction, exactly can bring, for middle-aged woman, can bring serious depression. And in this situation, usually it's syndrome of empty nest. Usually she is going to see psychologist or psychiatrist to help, because she can't cope with situation. And number three, it's really for me, my opinion as a psychiatrist with very wide experience, this one is sexual dysfunction. And in my opinion, sexual dysfunction. Usually people talking not too much about this problem, but in my opinion, for menopause, mostly of patients coming for assessment by psychologists and psychiatrists, exactly when they have hot flushing, when they have depression, but mostly of them, they're coming if they have sexual dysfunction. What is kind of sexual dysfunction usually women have at the time of menopause? It's coming low libido due to low estrogen level. It's going to be less sensitive to sexual arousal. It's coming problem with atrophic vaginitis, you know, because dry vagina. And it's coming painful sexual intercourse. Usually in this situation, it's affected woman, each woman, too much. Despite, for example, to have very good sexual partner, I mean husband, because it's middle age, and have good family, usually woman at the time of menopause refuse to have sexual intercourse. And in this situation, man, partner, husband is coming to see psychologist and psychiatrist and try to help. Because still middle age, woman is attractive, woman is active, sometimes is socially active, but due to painful sexual intercourse, she refuses usually to do everything. And in this situation, exactly, is going to be serious problem for woman, and exactly for sexual partner. Just the same, we have hypoactive sexual desire disorder. I explain explanation. We can explain low libido. You see, sometimes not pleasure, lost pleasure of sexual intercourse on ABCD. This one, it's symptom of hyperactive sexual desire disorder. And we have DSM-5 classification. Really, this one is HSDD. This one, we explain about this illness and DSM-5 classification. Usually occur when is persistent or recurrent absence of sexual fantasy or active or activity for or less or lost of sexual activity. This one is very common. You know, some of people suggest that woman is coming only if she has hot flushing or depression. But don't forget about sexual dysfunction. It's affected each woman because it's 50 plus, very attractive woman with good social position, with good family, and suddenly lost interest to sexual life. Exactly, it's affected. But we have another one, not only hyperactive sexual desire disorder. In my practice, I met too many patients when at the time of menopause, they suddenly developed sexual preoccupation, excessive sexual driver. And in my opinion, as a psychiatrist with very wide experience, I met more patient with sexual preoccupation, with excessive sexual driver, than, for example, patient who were suffering from hyperactive sexual desire disorder. Why sexual preoccupation and excessive sexual driver more serious? I explain just the same for you. Middle age, 50 plus, woman still looking young, very attractive, and at this, to have family, for example, sexual partner, husband, she stay with husband many, many years. And suddenly, at the time of menopause, she develop sexual preoccupation. What it mean? Her behavior suddenly change. She try to look young, she's using especially sexual outfit, try to go, for example, to nightclub, look for young sexual partner. And we have cases of sudden divorce, for no reason, but we know reason, really. But for people around, they can't understand what was happened. This type of patient, usually they're coming to see psychiatrist because they explain, I can't cope with my sexual driver. Help me, doctor. In this situation, exactly, it's more serious compared with another one. and psychiatrist exactly try to help. And end of my presentation, I'm going to have discussion about treatment, but I want to explain since beginning exactly in this situation. If, for example, patient suffering from hyperactive sexual desire disorder, we are using antidepressant, SSRI, we are using plus psychological assessment, you know, in this situation, small doses of psychostimulant, but for sexual preoccupation, for excessive sexual drive at the time of menopause, we are using usually mood stabilizer. It can be small doses carbamazepine or sodium, plus soft neuroleptic, antipsychotic. I prefer Seroquel or typical, it's from typical salpiride, sometimes risperidone, small dose olanzapine if it's combination with insomnia and ABCD. But at least course of treatment can take time. And in my wide practice in psychiatrist, I met more women who came for my assessment with sexual preoccupation, excessive sexual driver, sometimes with depression, and sometimes with hot flushing. Usually hot flushing, it's for gynecologists, and they try to sort out this problem. They don't need, for example, to send to psychologist or psychiatrist, because hormonal replacement treatment they're using for, especially for hot flushing, it can help just the same and for improve situation with hot flushing, just the same, and it can help and for depression, this combination. If it's depression, we are using SSR antidepressant, and just the same, it can help patient for surviving, and really depression at menopause time, it's not too difficult. We don't have, in my practice, I never had, for example, suicidal agitation at the time of menopause, usually level of mild or moderate sometimes. But sexual dysfunction still very serious for menopause. Why it's difficult, you know, because mostly of women, they're hiding information, especially if woman suffering from hyperactive sexual desire disorder. In this situation, husband or sexual partner, he's worried about situation. He tried to take her to see psychologist, psychiatrist, and ask to help. But if woman suffering from sexual preoccupation or excessive sexual driver, in this situation, it looks like hypomanic condition, you know, hypomanic condition. And she is coming usually to see psychologist and psychiatrist only really if she can develop lack of insight, lack of control on sexual driver. She is coming because she said, I can't cope, I am afraid to lose my family, I am afraid to lose my husband, but I can't control myself. Doctor, help me. And in my wide practice in psychiatry, I met this type of woman who used very high social position from good, rich family and ABCD, but suddenly developed this condition. Really, few months, we can sort out problem, but exactly go to see. In this situation, my opinion, you need to see psychiatrist. Because only we must be on medication, mood stabilizing, and small doses of soft neuroleptic, mostly of atypical neuroleptic, like I explained it, quantipine, seroquel, risperidone, or olanzapine, if, for example, you have insomnia or something else, and if you don't have problem with diabetes and ABCD, in this situation, you know. But it's exactly, it can take time. Psychological treatment, exactly, it can be a second step. And you can go to see psychologist and psychiatrist. Usually we try to help in this situation, not only woman and partner. We invite usually husband and to have discussion, at least like educational problem. He must understand it's not her bad behavior, it's mental problem, and she needs course of treatment to improve her condition and ABCD. At least treatment you understand. For hot flushing, I had usually patient, usually they came for my assessment with hot flushing. They came mostly of time for gynecologist, but only in cases if they had and hot flushing plus for example, insomnia and plus depression. This combination very often, physical symptom and mood symptom. And gynecologist sometimes can't help. He can help with hot flushing, with hormone replacement therapy. But with depression, exactly is difficult. And mostly of time of these patients, they are coming for my assessment. Exactly, we are using antidepressant, mostly of it's SSRI. I like sertraline, just the same. I like ibuprofen, duloxetine we are using. But for you, my advice, go to see your own psychiatrist who can explain for you situation and give for you advice how to cope with depression, with hot flushing. Hot flushing, very important, in my opinion, very important physical exercise. Usually my recommendation for hot flushing, it's swimming, number one. Swimming from physical exercise, exactly walking or gym can't help you, only swimming in cold water. And usually if somebody came for me, I gave advice swimming every morning 6 o'clock in cold water. For example, myself when I was in Zimbabwe 12 months, despite winter cold water, I used to swim every day 6 a.m. and it's helped a lot of energy, physical condition is very strong, very good mood. You are energetic since morning. And especially for hot flushing, my opinion, it's number one. Swimming in cold water. If you don't have swimming pool, at least shower, but not hot shower, not warm shower. It must be cool, and after that, exchange up to cold shower. Because I know women suffering. They're coming for duty, and sometimes they try to bring another dress or something else to change, because it's affected everything, affected your appearance. But at least swimming in cold water, cold shower, plus vitamin B6, please, and you will be fine with your hot flushing. Only combination and everything is going to be okay. For today, I don't want to have long presentation. My goal of my presentation today, it's my opinion, just the same, it's my opinion as a psychiatrist with very wide experience, how to help my sisters. How to help a woman, doesn't matter country, where do you stay, to do prevention of any mental problem at the time of menopause, and help at right time. Don't wait for serious depression, don't wait for serious sexual dysfunction. Take your sister, your brother, or yourself, my sister, you are watching my video, go to see psychologist or psychiatrist, and they can help you to survive at this difficult time. And exactly prevention, physical exercise, like I explained, if it's possible, swimming in cold water, but cold water, exactly cold water, walking, better to walking early morning when it's a little bit cool, not walking at hot time, you know. Exactly, it's change environment, my best advice. Change environment, guys. If you have opportunity to change environment, suddenly take car, take your family, your husband, your kids, go outside, and to be in touch is reality. Mother Nature is healer number one. Just the same I want to explain for you. Go to forest, go to mountain area, go to somewhere. Change environment. You can't stay the same in the same place, the same house, the same flat. Go to change environment. And communication. Communication is very important. You know, communication with your kids, communication with your friends, not any social isolation. Because another mistake of women, if they have this condition, like hot flushing, physical condition, like depression or sexual dysfunction, they try to isolate yourself and they don't want to be open for anyone. No. Try to be open, at least communicate with your member of family. It's very important for everyone. You can't be socially and emotionally isolated during this time. For today, that's all. I love you, my dear subscriber. Stay together with Dr. Posko and waiting for my next video. Bye, guys.